So what is up, guys? Back with another video here, and today we are going to do a catch, clean, cook on bluegill. Well, the cooking part I can't do, mainly because of my kid. And my goal is to get about one or two more, and I'm gonna flay them. I'm gonna show you guys how to clean them and how to catch them. So what we're gonna do is, I have my little crappie rod here, and what we're gonna do is, you can use night crawlers, you can use rooster tails. Rooster tails look like this, and you can also use red worms or blood worms. And so what you do is, you're gonna grab your hook, take your worm, and just thread it all the way through, go right back, and just keep on doing that till you have no more space left on it. But you want to make sure to expose the barb on the hook, and that's what it should look like after. I'm using a 1.8 ounce jig head, and we're gonna go cast this sucker out. I know it's a change from all the blackbird hunting. I know those were getting annoying, and I'm sorry I haven't posted in the last 2 weeks. Mainly, I mean, in the last 2 months, because there's nothing to film. Uh-oh. Rookie move. Open up the veil. And I might catch a bass. And that's not what I'm after, unless they get gut hooked. Oh, got them. Uh-oh, my camera. Well, I had a bite. I'm gonna recast. I'm just using a stick to hold my rod while I can just watch the line. I'm using no bobber. You can use a bobber. However you like, however depth. And I'm probably gonna do a couple more minutes of fishing, and we'll see. Let's see if we catch anything. Sometimes it can be pretty slow. Today was slow for bluegill. I only caught like 5 today. And I didn't keep 2 of them because they were full of eggs. And you don't get any bites, you can reel it in. I just don't like waiting. Well, we got a bite. My worm's almost pretty much gone. Focus. So now we're gonna re-rig. This is probably gonna be my last worm of the night that I'm gonna use. And hopefully we can get one more. I think I might put 2 worms on here, because I want to really maximize my chances of catching them. And if, like, you do have the hook not exposed, just take some of the worm off. Just pinch it use scissors, pliers to cut it. And that should be good. I'm sorry I can't do the cooking part. I just suck at it. So I'm not even gonna attempt it. This is what two red worms look like on a 1/8 ounce blue jig head. I know it's a little overkill for them, but I mean, like, these are big bluegills. They're not 5-6 inches. They're like 8-10 inches. They're big ones. You don't usually catch them anywhere else. I've managed this pond for a long time, and it's finally starting to pay off, all the managing I've done. And it's all starting to pay off over all the things I've done. What the heck? There's a whole bunch of dust clouds. Oh, just got a bite. My rod twitches. Looks like I got one worm left on my hook. And hopefully I can make it happen. I'm sorry if I go out of screen. I just need to set my rod down. And whenever I go to set the hook, I need to go over and grab it. If you hear splashing noises, that's just the fish already on the stinger. So, what are those fish doing? I caught one of my best fish out of here. Well, best bluegill out of here today. It's like a pound. It's huge. Well, I told you how to catch them, but we had no luck today. I'm gonna go get my stuff ready to clean. I'm just gonna use two buckets, one to put the guts and stuff in, and one to set my board on, my cutting board. And I know this video is gonna get demonetized and stuff, but I'm gonna try not to make it too graphic for YouTube. I'm sorry if there's stuff in the way of the camera, because I'm packed down with stuff. I got a fishing rod, a stringer, box of worms, a crankbait, a spinner. I got too many things on me. In total today, I probably caught 20 fish, 20, 30 fish. Most of them are bass. If you hear people in the background, it's probably my brother. Yeah, it's my brother and my cousin screaming. They built a pillow fort, and they
don't want to spend the night in there?
Yeah, sure. So, we're gonna...
What are you doing with your phone?
No, I made it, okay. And, well, I'm getting my three fish off my stringer.
Hold on.
I'm gonna set you down. here's my PB. He's a, I'm not like, he shrunk after he died. Cause I put him out of his misery. I'm gonna go get my cutting board. I'll be right back. I'm back. I'm not done, but I need the most important thing, cutting board. Cutting board. What else do I need? I think that's it. Well, I'm gonna set you guys down, and I'm probably just gonna show one fish that I'm gonna clean today. I'm not gonna go all out. I'm gonna do the smallest one. Jace, be quiet. My brother, he's on a bike and he's being pretty annoying. I'm not gonna lie, he's being pretty annoying. I don't want to show you. I'm just going to show you, like, the aftermath. I'm going to... So, I go behind the gills. Go all the way to the backbone. I switch my blade. And just follow the backbone. You want a good, sharp flay knife. And, And if you go through the backbone, that's all right, because you can just cut that. You can just go over top of where you went in the backbone, cut the meat off of the fish, and just keep on skinning. And whenever you get to only skin, you cut it off and you get this skin still attached. Some people will keep the skin on it and scale it and stuff and just cut the head off and gut it, but I'm not like that. I just like frying it in the deep fryer or the pan with a little salt and pepper, and that's really it. And it turns out pretty good. I like them in nuggets because they're just easier to deal with. Jesus. Start on this other side. If you keep on hearing a door shutting, it's my cousins and brother. That's what you get after. Just a nice, clean little flay off the fish. Just soak it in some water or salt water. If you're gonna eat it quick, I prefer salt water, but if you're not, just regular water would do fine. I do the same side. The same thing to the other side. I hope you enjoyed my videos. If you like this one, go check out my other videos. Blackbird hunting. I know they get boring and stuff, but it helps the channel out a lot. If you just go back and watch those videos if you haven't. one shout outs to Kendall Gray, Flair Fishing, and a couple other people. Flair, I just like your videos and stuff. Kendall, I like pretty much everything you do.
Kill a buck.
Just kill a spike. Just do something. Kill a doe. I know it was a hard decision if you had to kill the kid or the mom, but just take one. Take one out. Hopefully we can. This fillet is way better. Whenever you get done with a carcass, it should look like this. I know, demonetization. You should be able to see through it. There's a little bone that runs up it. If you have sunlight, if you look, you should be able to see the bone sticking out and stuff. And that's whenever you know you missed no meat. I hope you enjoyed this video.
And don't forget to like and subscribe. It means a lot. I appreciate it.
Jace, really. That was my brother. Normally they hate being on camera. Hopefully my brother gets his YouTube channel. I forget what his YouTube channel name's gonna be though. If you go over the ribcage, you can get some YouTube. Like, subscribe, and hope you enjoyed this video. Go check out my other videos. Look up Outdoor Kid, and see ya. Peace.